We're going to get into a whole list of stuff, including the Trent Reznor BS. We're going to get into Soundgarden rumors.
It's Q101 Chicago's alternative, Sherman and Tingle. Who do we have in the studio right now, Tingle?
It's the brother Chris Cornell in the studio. What's happening, dude?
Hi, Tingle.
How you doing? What kind of set did you do? Obviously, new stuff off Scream.
Yeah, I did kind of a mixture of everything. I do whatever I want, sort of.
Okay. So,
going back like as far as 92, kind of last night.
Sometimes, oh, nice.
Sometimes I go earlier.
Rockstar to rockstar. What's Axl Rose like?
Yeah, Chris Cornell.
He treated me very well.
He was a good guy to you?
Very well, yes.
Okay.
Yeah.
Because he gets a real bad image, you know, in the media, talking about his, his temper tantrums and stuff like that. And I always wanted curious, from rockstar to rockstar, was he a regular kind of guy?
Yeah, to me, he was really kind of, he's a little eccentric, but...
is it a lead singer thing, like bonding in that way, or like was he?
I guess so. I mean, I'm sort of normal. I can bond with anybody, but I think for him at the time, he thought of my band as being kind of something that inspired him, and he was very supportive of music and musicians that inspired him. He treated us great. I mean, I can't really complain about it.
First of all, honor, pleasure for the lips you get to talk to you, sir.
Thank you very much. Personally.
Well, I mean, like many people, I first got exposed to you through, I'm as a fan of all your projects through Soundgarden. What is the likelihood of, a potential Soundgarden reunion and potential tour or any projects on the horizon?
Well, I've always answered it the same way, which is
kind of
just you just never know.
You're still good friends with all those guys, right?
Yeah, I still talk to them and. You just never know.
You ever get sick of hearing yourself on the radio, Chris Cornell?
It's worse than that. My son and daughter, my son Christopher and daughter Tony, but especially Christopher, refuses to listen to anything but me in the car, whenever we're in the car. So
really?
There's a whole bunch of CDs in the CD changer, and usually he just starts screaming, and you have to play it. So, I get really sick of it.
Because you're like SpongeBob SquarePants right now.
Exactly. That's exactly right.
Okay. What bands or artists have influenced you the most in becoming such a great artist?
The first band that I ever was really into, I was a little kid, and it was the Beatles. For me, I got into it so young. Like, I became such a fan of music at such an early age that it really... There was never that moment where I heard music and thought, this is what I want to do. I just sort of, it was always kind of a given, and the Beatles was kind of the first thing. And it was their whole catalog. It was from, their pop period to the period where they had beards and stuff, all kind of at the same time, because I sort of commandeered all their whole catalog of records and sat in a room like at 8, 9 years old and listened to Beatles records all day.
My big thing to ask is, you got such an incredible range. Do you have any exercises or whatnot that you do to keep your vocal cords stretched out?
I did two things. One of them is, like, if I'm at home and I'm not touring or rehearsing, I will sing to records. And often I do that driving around. Like, I have a version of Scream with no lead vocal in it. And I put it in my car and I drive around and sing the thing.
How's your family, dude? How's kids? How's life on the road with not seeing the kids for a while?
Well, we miss our kids. It gets tough. It's like I think 48 hours is like great for any parents to have, like 48 hours to just get away from it. After that, it's hard.
You miss them after that?
Yeah, big time. Yeah, gets hard.
All right, Chris, let's talk about this Twitter thing. Now, we're getting a lot of texts on it. When the story first came out about Trent Reznor talking crap about your new record and stuff like that, you're a Twitter junkie. We've heard about that. What was your initial thoughts when you first saw that?
I never saw it, and I've never read it. And
you heard?
Yeah, I didn't even know it was a Twitter, because I think at the time I didn't even know what Twitter was. I just heard that, I guess I assumed he blogged it or something. But the timing was kind of good. Because I think that was Street Week for my album. It was when it was just coming out. So, like, suddenly there was a story people wanted to talk about my album.
So you gave your album press.
Exactly. It was great. I don't even think he probably realized that it would be something that people would want to talk about so much.
Has there ever been beef in the past between you and him with Trent?
No, I've never even met him. I don't know him.
Does Chris Cornell have to ask his wife, hey, can I buy this?
Can I have some money, honey?
If there's something I want, yeah, absolutely. I would absolutely ask her. She's like a co-manager. She's definitely on top of every aspect of my business all the time. She everything that I can't deal with just because my brain can't do it, those are the things she excels at.
Like what? Like what can't you do and she can?
Well, like I'm the right brain, just sort of like head in the clouds, artistic type guy that wants to be able to be eccentric and inconsistent and all of the things that, you know, you would expect from that. And she's the opposite. She remembers numbers. She remembers what time
she
to call someone. She pays the bills. She knows how much money we have. I'm not much of a materialist. And I learned that kind of from, you know, you're in a band, you're making music all the time, writing songs. I spend all my energy doing that. And then my band had some success. Suddenly there's money and there's, you know, I started seeing like a lot of friends of mine get really distracted by money because they'd start going and doing things that they maybe had always been interested in, that being a musician suddenly afforded them to be able to do. And for me, I didn't have any of those things. I just wanted to,
didn't become an indie driver or something.
No, I wanted to just keep making music. So it's like it didn't really, I sort of realized I was a non-materialist and that stuff didn't really matter that much to me. And that nothing really kind of beat that feeling of writing a song.
We appreciate you hanging out, brother.
Thank you.
Album's been in store since last month, the new album Scream. Thank you, Chris Cornell.